Hi all, with this video tutorial we are going to discuss about variables. So let's first see what is a variable. A variable is actually a name which refers to a memory location. For an example, say now you are going to create a variable in your program, and then that variable means it's just a name, but it refers to a memory location where that whatever the value will be stored in, right? A variable include three things, which we call as identifier, data type, and a value. Those are the three things that every variable has. And other than that, there's a scope for each and every variable, right? The variable ekak kiyanne attarama ape memory allocation eke ehema naththam memory අපි වැලියු එකක් ස්ටෝර් කරපුවාම ඒ මෙමරියට අපි දාන රෙෆරන්ස් එකක් ඒකට දාන නේම් එකක් කියලා කියන අපි වේරියබල් එකට වේරියබල් එක හැදිලා තියෙන්නේ අයිඩෙන්ටිෆයර් එකක් එහෙම නැත්නම් වේරියබල් නේම් එකකින් ඒ වගේම ටයිප් එකකින් සහ වැලියු එකකින් එතකොට ඊට අමතරව වේරියබල් වලට ස්කෝප් එකක් තියෙනවා ස්කෝප් එක කියන්නේ ඒ වේරියබල් එක ප්‍රෝග්‍රෑම් එකේ ඇක්සස් කරන්න පුළුවන් ප්‍රමාණය එහෙම නැත්නම් ඒක visible වෙන ප්‍රමාණයට තමයි අපි scope එක කියලා කියන්නේ right so let's see how we are creating a variable in our programs java වල කොහොමද අපි variable එකක් හදන්නේ කියලා බලමු declaring a variable when you are going to declare a variable that means you are not assigning a value but if it is initialization that means you are assigning a value right so when you are declaring or initializing a value first you have to give the type of that variable and then you have to give the identifier which means the name of your variable right you can assign a name which should be a meaningful and then you have to end it with a semicolon right if you are going to assign a value you can give the equal sign and then whatever the value can be assigned right එතකොට මෙතන තියෙනවා type එක ඉස්සලාම ඔයාලා type එක දෙන්න ඕනි ඊට පස්සේ identifier එකට නමක් දෙන්න ඕනි ඒ කියන්නේ ඔයාලට කැමති නමක් දෙන්න පුළුවන් මෙතනදී හැබැයි meaningful නමක් දෙන්න ඕනි ඒ වගේම තව naming conventions we will discuss later ඒ naming conventions වලට අනුකූල නමක් මෙතන දෙන්න ඕනි ඊට පස්සේ semicolon තියන්න ඕනි ඔයගලන්ට ඕන නම් you can give equal sign and assign a value right so that's how we are normally creating a variable so this type actually it can be a primitive data type which will be discussed later and name of a class or interface me type එක java වල තියෙන primitive data type එකක් වෙන්න පුළුවන් එහෙම නැත්නම් class name එකක් වෙන්න පුළුවන් එහෙම නැත්නම් interface name එකක් වෙන්න පුළුවන් හරි අපි discuss කරමු types gene issarahata now let's see how to assign a name or else how to assign an identifier for our variable variable ekkada api namak daana kota emena identifier ekak daana kota we have to obey some rules there are some rules right we have to consider these rules when we are giving a name for a variable not only actually a variable but also for a class methods we have to think these things when we are assigning a name for a any kind of identifier hari etoda api ithuwath class ekkada variable ekkada method ekkada namak daana kota apita menne me karunu gena hitanna wenna right all identifiers should be begin with a letter or else underscore or else dollar mark right ekena hama identifier ekakma whether it is a variable whether it is a class name whether it is a method name you have to start with a letter that might be a to z letter or dollar mark or underscore other than that you can't start any kind of an identifier with a number or else any other special characters right and after the first character identifiers can have any combination of characters right ekena palaweni character එක දැම්මට පස්සේ පළවෙනි එක ඔයාලා මේ කියන rule එකට අනුව දැම්මට පස්සේ ඊට පස්සේ ඔයාලට combination එක කැමති එකක් add කරන්න පුළුවන් but you have to remember that there shouldn't be any white space in between the variable name or else class name or else method name again spaces තියෙන්න බෑ it should be a one single word and you can't use any keyword in java as an identifier and you have to remember that all the identifiers are case sensitive right those are some naming conventions that you have to remember when you are assigning a identifier name right okay that's about identifiers then let's see what are the types in java or else we call as data types right so as you heard java programming is said to be a strongly typed and statically typed language strongly typed means it performs strict type checking to ensure that whatever the conversion is valid statically typed language means all the variables have a specific data type right which will be known at the compile time so that are some features of java programming and then let's see what are the data types in java the data types actually we can categorize into two sections in java primitives and reference so let's move on to the primitive data types first there are eight primitive data types we can identify in java so that primitive data types can be further categorized into boolean and number numbers further can be categorized as integer and floating point right so under the integer there are five data types in java and under the floating point we can identify two types of data types right and you have to remember that these all primitive data types are keywords in java ne primitive data types atama java wala thiyena keywords right okay let's move on to primitive data types further first let's see what is boolean boolean actually can hold either true or false true hari false hari values hold karanna thamai boolean kiyana data type e use karanna puluwa char is holding any kind of unicode character ekak kiyuwama agula dannawa if you search in the internet all the characters maybe a to z numbers other special characters and there are lot of unicode characters ඊට අමතරව තව ගොඩක් තියෙනවා characters ඔයගොල්ලෝ search කරලා බලන්න ඒ හැම unicode character එකක්ම all the unicode characters can be used with char java වල අපිට ඕන නම් ඒක පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන් char කියන data type එකත් එක්ක right and then you have byte byte is actually said to be signed integer එකක් කියන්නේ මොකක්ද if you can work with negative values also negative numbers which we called as signed integer එහෙනම් අපි ඒවට signed integer කියනවා negative values එකත් ඒක represent කරන්න පුළුවන් නම් උගලන්ට පේනවා ඇති byte short int long all are signed integers so for byte it can store up to 8 bits bit 8ක් store කරන්න පුළුවන් bit 8ක් කියන්නේ the first bit should be the sign පළවෙනි bit එක අපිට අයින් කරන්න වෙනවා ඒකේ sign එක හොයාගන්න. ඒ කියන්නේ if the first bit is 1 then the number is negative. If the first bit is 0 then we call as the number is positive. එතකොට positive පැත්තට ඒ කියන්නේ බිංදුවේ ඉඳන් positive පැත්තට අපිට තියෙන්නේ up to 127. මොකද පළවෙනි නම්බර එක අපි බිඳුව කරන්න ඕනි. ඒ නිසා අපිට 127යි numbers ගන්න පුළුවන්. positive පැත්තේ. හැබැයි negative පැත්තේ if the first letter is 1 then that is negative. ඒ කියන්නේ negative පැත්තේ 128ක් තියෙනවා. එතකොට ඍණ 128 ඉඳන් from -128 to 127 we can get byte as the data type. right? හරි ඔයගොල්ලන්ට මේ numbers range එක store කරන්න ඕන නම් you can use byte short 16 bits short වල store කරන්න පුළුවන් 16 bit වෙනකම් integer we can store up to 32 bit long we can store up to 64 bit right and then you have these floating points means whatever the when you have a fractional part we call it as floating point numbers IEEE 754 is kind of a format which we use for the floating point in Java it include actually two formats single precision and double precision in single precision there are 32 bits මේ IEEE 754 කියන format එකේ single precision double precision කියලා වර්ග දෙකක් තියෙනවා ඒ single precision එකේදී bit 32යි අපිට අවශ්‍ය වෙන්නේ ඒ කියන්නේ format එකට double precision එකේදී bits 64ක් ඕනි වෙනවා ඒ නිසා because of that you have two data types again float and double where you can store any kind of a decimal point value right so that's about data types again you have this integral data types actually we can say from char to long char indang long denakan me okkoma integral data types idiyata thamai api identify karanne and you have to remember that all numeric types are signed hama numeric type ekakma signed ekenne monade wad kiyanne api signed kiyanne negative values ut represent karanna puluwam widiyata pawichchi karanne edora there are no unsigned types in java java wala unsigned data types neha kiyala kiyenawa edora all numeric types are signed right so integral types we can include byte short int long and char okay and that's about integral data types and then there are some operators we can use with integral data types me integral data types එක අපිට පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන් operators integral data types එක විතරක් නෙමෙයි තව ගොඩක් ඒවත් එක්ක පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන් සමහර ඒවා ඒතර මෙතන කියනවා operators there are set of operators you can see some relational operators අපි මේවට comparison operators කියලා එහෙම නැත්නම් relational operators කියලා greater than no equal less than no equal 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 not equal these kind of things are these kind of operators we call as comparison operators and then you have numerical operators also called as sometimes arithmetic operators plus division multiplication subtraction and also there are some increment operators decrement operators and bitwise operators you can see here some bitwise operators right all those operators together we called as numerical operators oy okkoma tikata api ekathu vela ekathu karala kiyenawa numerical operators kiyala thara eka athule tiyenna puluwan arithmetic operators increment decrement operators and bitwise operators as well conditional operators whatever the question mark and the colon is said to be conditional operators casting operators actually it used for the convert from integral values to any other numeric type ekeni mokak hari integral value ekak mokak hari ani data type ekka cast karana oni unama use karana operators walata thamai cast operators kiyala kiyanne and for the string concatenation you can use plus mark strings ogol pawichchi karana nan ewa concat karanna you can use plus mark as an operator right you have to remember that plus mark also used as a arithmetic operator ekak widiyata plus ekak use karana habai string waladi eka concat karanna pawichchi karana right and then these are the floating point that's what I have described man describe kara floating point kiyanne mokakda kiyala we have two data types float and double kiyala deka tiyenawa එතකොට fractional part එකක් තියෙනේ වට එහෙම නැත්නම් decimal part එකක් තියෙන දශම ස්ථාන තියෙන values අපිට store කරන්න පුළුවන් float and double වල and then here you have something like NaN that means final results cannot be defined අන්තිමට floating point වල තියෙන මොකක් හරි අපි floating point use කරලා operation එකක් කරනවා නම් if the final result is not defined then the output will be NaN right? Let's see some example. Api examples karaddi balamu meka kohomada wenney kiyala. These results are represented by a special value. A special value ekak thamai, that is called as NaN. NaN means not a number, right? So that's about floating point data types. And then you have the Boolean type and Boolean values. Boolean means actually true or false. With Boolean values, Boolean types, you can use some operators, the same operators, ekek operators walaka Boolean ewat pawichchi karanna pulwan, ara api kalin discuss karapu operators me tamai metanak tiyenne. And then what is this reference type? Etukota dan e tamai primitive data types tika. Ilangata tiyenawa apita reference type kiyala ekak. Mokakda me reference type kiyanne? Reference type is you can use any class name, interface name, or else array name as the data type. Ara primitive data types walata amathara class name ekak, interface ekak namak, array ekak namak, data type ekak widiyata pawichchi karanawa nan, in that case we call as reference type. Right, so if you think about like a string, if you have heard about string is actually a class. Eka string kiyana ekak data type, primitive data types walata dala naththe, string kiyanne class ekak. Ara string ekak api pawichchi karanawa kiyala api class name ekak thamai pawichchi karanne. Because of that, that is also a reference type, right? Other than that, if you are creating any class, the class name can be used as a reference type, right? Okay, that's about data types in Java. Let's see some examples. Balamu den examples kiyapaya kohomada karanne kiyala. Okay, I have a small code here which is named as a test variable. Class එකක් හදාගත්ත test variable කියලා පොඩියට. ඉතින් ඒකේ මම main method එක ලියලා තියෙනවා. Let's see how to work with this kind of variables. අපි බලමු කොහොමද මේ variables එක වැඩ කරන්නේ කියලා. ඉතින් මම ඒකට මෙන්න data types ටික කොහොමද පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ කියලා පොඩ්ඩක් example එකක් කියලා දෙන්නම් ඔයාලට. Let's see how we use these data types. So as I explained, first you have to give the type of the variable like a hadana kota wala issellama type ekak denna oni api thum integer kiyala, then you have to give int, and then you have to assign a variable name. Variable ekata namak oyala assign karanna oni. So that name should not start with any kind of a number. Number ekkin patan ganna ba manam waradi. You can start with a letter, pithum h kiyala. So now it's okay, and then if you want you can add the value. Make it on a value ekak add karanna puluwan me vidihata, right? Okay, let's try to create another variable as char. Right, so if you are assigning a value for a char variable, you have to assign that value in between single quotation. චාවලට වැලියු එකක් දානවා නම් ඒක අනිවාර්යෙන් සිංගල් කෝටේෂන් ඇතුලේ දාන්න මතක තියාගන්න. Right? Other than that, let's say dot. Okay. Okay. And now let's try to print these values. අපි මේ values ටික print කරලා බලමු. මොකද වෙන්නේ කියලා අපේ කෝඩ් එක රන් වෙනවද කියලා. So this is called as string concatenation. ඔගලන් පේනවා ඇති මෙතන මේකට අපි කියනවා string concat කරනවා කියලා. ඒ කියන්නේ මෙතනදී වෙලා තියෙන්නේ මේ plus mark එකෙන් I explained you that there is a string concatenation. Plus mark also used for the summation, that means addition. Addition එකටත් plus mark එක arithmetic operator එකක් විදිහට පාවිච්චි කරනවා. Also we can use in concatenation as well. concat කරන්නත් අපිට පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන්. අපි බලමු ඉතුරු අනික් ඒවා දෙකත්. මම print කරලා පෙන්වන්නම් කොහොමද වෙන්නේ කියලා. Age, then I'm going to print grade. And the GPA. Right? Okay, let's see what happens. Now you have an error. You have an error, you know. කොතනද වැරද්ද මෙතන මම ඊ එකක් දාලා තියෙනවා ඒකද වැරද්ද කියලා අපි බලමු හැබැයි ඒක නෙවෙයි අපි බලමු right now you have the end it's because if you are working with float float එක වැඩ කරනවා නම් you have to mention that this value is a float so because of that at the end of this value you have to mention as f f කියලා mention කරන්න වෙනවා ඔයාලා float කියන එක පාවිච්චි කරනවා හරි ඉතින් අපි බලමු Now it's correct. Now you can see the answers, right? So that's how you can use the primitive data types. And as I told you, we have another data type as string, which is a reference type. The string kila mama name kila danna. Right when you are assigning a value for a string value string data type make sure to use it in between double quotation right ඊට පස්සේ මම නමත් මේ විදිහටම print කරන්නම් Oh, now let's see what will be the output. Okay, now name is also printed. So that's how it works. විදියට තමයි values වැඩ කරන්නේ. Again, I will explain how to work with boolean. අපි boolean එකක් හදුවේ නෑ. ඒ නිසා boolean එක කොහමද වෙන්නේ කියලා කියන්නම්. Boolean එකට අපිට insert කරන්න පුළුවන් true or false විතරයි. එතකොට either you can insert true or false. So here I have created a variable as pass fail. That means whether the person is pass or fail. එතකොට pass නම් true කියලා print වෙනවා නැත්නම් false කියලා print වෙනවා. ඒ වගේ ඔයගොල්ලන්ට true නම් true දාන්න පුළුවන් false නම් false කියලා දාන්න පුළුවන්. So it can hold only true false values විතරයි මේකට hold කරන්න පුළුවන් ඒ නිසා මතක තියාගන්න true false values විතරක් boolean වලට assign කරන්න right okay you can see if I change this to false So that's how it works. For the age, I will change it integer to byte. Right? It's because byte can store, you know, byte can store up to 8 bits, which means -128 to 127. You can int byte 32 bit store byte byte age right? I will show you one thing. Now I am going to insert 100. It works fine. But now I am going to insert 130. Let's see what happens. That's an error because byte can hold up to 127. Because if you see the byte, තියා ගන්න පුළුවන් අපි බලමු 127 ගහලා let's see what happen no errors and it will be printed but other than 127, you can't insert, right? So that's about byte. විදිහට තමයි අනිත් හැම integer type value එකක්ම ඒ කියන්නේ මේ 8 bit 16 bits එයාගේ තියෙන bits ගානේ මෙහාට එයාගේ hold කරලා තියාගන්න බෑ ඒක ඔයාල මතක තියාගන්න ඒ කියන්නේ ලොකු number එකක් store කරන්න ඕන නම් you have to use long if you want to store any lengthier number then you can use long right so it's according to whatever the value that you are going to store okay so that's about initializing values other than that there was something like meke tibuna podi deyak tava nan kiyala ulana mata kathi nan kiyana eka nan kiyana value ekene as I explained the result of some of the operations on float are not defined karanna bari values thiyenawa nan thamai nan kiyala inne balamu eka kohomada wenne kiyala mama gulanda pennanawa I will show you I'm going to create a float value. Something like this, which is a minus value. You can see minus 5.89. Right? And I want to print out.println. I want to print the square root of this value. Don't think about this one. I will explain it later. Math dot square කියන එක මම පස්සේ explain කරන්නම් මොකද වෙන්නේ කියලා. That will be a NaN. Not a number. So here what happens is math is actually a package which includes several mathematical operations like square root, power, absolute values. එවගේ math කියන package එක ඇතුලේ තියෙනවා. Math is actually inside the lang package. Lang කියන එකේ තමයි තියෙන්නේ. ඒ නිසා you don't need to import any predefined classes here but not import karanne na you can directly use the math package and it include sqrt which is return the square root of any given value the value I am giving here is -5.89 kene ke square root ekak ganna kiyala man tiyenne ekaṭa minus value ekak square root ekak ganna bæ because of that it will be printed as nan in name not a number can I print kala thiyena ogalanda peenawa athi right so other than that I will explain some features in math eke thiyena thawa apita pawichchi karanna puluwan dewal tikak man kiyannam system without print so math can be used for many operations sqrt actually return the square root of 64 right it will return the value that means square root of 64 square root එක මෙතන පෙන්වනවා and then I will give another I will show you another one math.power math.pow or math.power math.power is used to get the power of any value that means say I want to get the square value of 6 square pi වර්ගය මට ගන්න ඕනි එතකොට මේ කියන්නේ base value එක this is the exponent value එක ඒ කියන්නේ වර්ගය කියන එක ඉතින් answer එක අපි බලමු කොහොමද වෙන්නේ කියලා let's see what will be the answer right you can see Likewise, there are several functions, or else we can call methods in math package, where you can use for mathematical operations, right? So that's about this video tutorial. Actually, I want to discuss about variables, how to create variables, and how to print the values of a variables, how to assign values two variables, how to get that values, and other than that, I wanted to explain about float. Here also some math package. I explained how to work with math package. So that's about variables, right? So let's meet with the next video tutorial soon. Thank you.